गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, वेलकम टू मैथमेटिक्स क्लास ऑफ ग्रेड 8 एंड दिस इज माय लेक्चर नंबर 3 ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 4 प्रैक्टिकल ज्योमेट्री. दीज आर द टॉपिक्स टू बी कवर्ड इन टुडेज लेक्चर. इन दिस लेक्चर नंबर 3 वी शैल लर्न हाउ टू कंस्ट्रक्ट अ क्वाड्रिलेटरल व्हेन टू एडजेसेंट साइड्स एंड 3 एंगल्स आर नोन टू अस. Second case, we shall learn how to construct a quadrilateral when 3 sides and 2 included angles are given. 3 measurements of 3 sides will be given to us and the 2 included angles between these 3 sides will also be given to us. So, these are the 2 cases which we will be learning today in this lecture number 3. So let us begin with the very first case, that is when 2 adjacent sides and 3 angles are known to us. So let us see the very first case, that is how to construct a quadrilateral when 2 adjacent sides and 3 angles are known to us. Firstly, dear children, I will be explaining this case with the help of an example. After that, we shall discuss exercise 4.3 questions. So let us begin with the example. The example is, construct a quadrilateral, MIST, M-I-S-T, where MI is equal to 3.5 centimeters, IS is equal to 6.5 centimeters, angle M is equal to 75 degree, angle I is equal to 105 degrees and angle S is equal to 120 degree. So dear children, I hope you all remember the very first step. What is the first step? We are supposed to make the rough sketch and then after that final sketch we will make. And last but not the least, we need to write these steps of construction. So these are the steps which you are supposed to follow in practical geometry questions. So let us begin with the rough sketch. So dear children, this is the example which I am going to discuss. That is, we need to construct a quadrilateral MIST, that is MIST. MI equals 3.5 centimeters, IS equals 6.5 centimeters, angle M is equal to 75 degrees, angle I is equal to 105 degrees and angle S is equal to 120 degrees. This is the rough sketch I have made. MI is equal to 3.5 centimeters, IS is equal to 6.5 centimeters. This side is ST, this side is unknown to us, this side is also unknown to us. So angle M is given to us as 75 degrees. Angle I is equal to 105 degrees and angle S is equal to 120 degrees. So dear children, you can see that in this question or in this example, we need to make or take this MI as base because all these 2 angles are known to us and the measurement of this side is also known to us. Or you can take IS as base. The measurement of this side is known to us and these 2 angles are also with us. So either you can take MI as base or IS as base. Now I am taking MI as base. So MI equals 3.5 centimeter. So I will be making 3.5 centimeter now with the help of scale like this. So this is MI, that is equal to 3.5 centimeter. After that, I need to make an angle of 105 degree at MI and 75 degree at M. So I am making 105 degree angle at I point, vertex. Like this. Now I am going to make a semicircle at I and then 60 degree angle and then 120 degree angle. And dear children, 105 degree angle lies between 90 degree and 120 degree. This 105 degree angle lies between these two angles, that is 90 degree angle and 120 degree angle. So we are supposed to make this angle 105 degree between 90 and 120 degree. Like this I will be making now. I have made a semicircle at point I, at vertex I. Now I am making an arc of 60 degree, 120 and then 180 degree. After that, as I told you that this 105 degree angle lies between 90 and 120 degree, I need to first make the angle of 90 degrees. So, you all know that it lies between 60 and 120 degree. So, I am joining first 120 degree arc, or you can make directly between 60 degree and 120 degree. Now you can see I have made 90 degree angle. Now between 90 and 120, I will be making 105 degree angle. So, this angle is 105 degree. From this point till this point, this complete angle is 105 degree. So, you can write like this. After that, I need to place an arc of 6.5 cm from I so as to get the vertex S. So, IS is 6.5 cm. So, measuring 6.5 from the, using the scale and placing an arc with the help of compass. So this point is S point. Now at this point S, I need to make an angle of 120 degree. So, all of you know how to make the angle of 120 degree. So, I am making now. This is an arc of 60 degree. This is an arc of 120 degree. So, I am erasing first this question and then I will be joining this line. Now you can see I have made an angle of 120 degree. Now after this, at M I need to make an angle of 75 degree. So let us make the angle of 75 degree, and this 75 degree angle lies between 60 degree and 90 degree. So firstly I need to make the angle 60 degree, then 90 degree, and then between these two angles, that is the bisector of these two, will be 75 degree. So let us now make the semicircle and then all the angles. Now I am making the angle of 90 degree. After this, I need to make 75 degree angle between 60 and 90 degree. So making the angle 75 degree now. Now this angle is 75 degrees and this will meet this line at T. So our quadrilateral MIST is ready now. Dear children, you must be able to see now that firstly what I have done, I have taken MI as 3.5 centimeter. Then at I, with I as center, I have made an angle of 105 degree. After that, I made an angle of 120 degree at S. And then 75 degree angle at M, and now I have joined this line with this line S line, and then here this will be the point T. So MIST is our required quadrilateral. Now dear children, on the basis of the concept or the example which I have shown you, I am going to discuss NCERT exercise 4.3 question number 1 second part. The question is, construct a quadrilateral plan, that is PLAN, and the dimensions are given. PL is equal to 4 centimeters, LA is equal to 6.5 centimeters, angle P equals 90 degree, angle A is equal to 110 degree, angle N is equal to 85 degree. So these are the dimensions given to us. Let us get started with this with the construction of this quadrilateral with rough sketch. Firstly, we need to make the rough sketch, final sketch then, and then lastly steps of construction. So let us make the rough sketch now. Now this is the question which I am going to discuss with you. We need to construct quadrilateral plan, that is PLAN, and these are the dimensions given to us. This is basically question number 1, second part, exercise 4.3 I am discussing. Question number 1, second part, exercise 4.3. This is the rough sketch, that is PLAN. I have taken like this. PL is 4 centimeters. Angle LA is 6.5 centimeters. Angle P is given to us as 90 degrees. Angle A is given to us as 110 degrees and angle N is given to us as 85 degrees. So these are the dimensions which are given to us. Now, dear children, in this case, what we are supposed to do? Firstly, if we look at this rough sketch carefully, you will find that these two angles are known to us, but its dimension is unknown. The dimension of PL is known to us, but this angle is unknown to us, so we cannot make this angle. Now, if I talk about LA, dimension is known to us, but again this angle is unknown to us, so I cannot take this side as base until and unless I know need to know the dimension of this side. I cannot take this side until and unless I know come to know the measurement of this angle L. Same is the case with this side. In this side, if you look at this side, we do not know the dimension of this line. So firstly, can I calculate this angle L? Yes, definitely we can calculate this angle L, and you must be knowing that sum of all the angles of a quadrilateral equals 360 degree. So firstly, what we are supposed to do? We are supposed to calculate this angle L, because we cannot find the dimensions of these two sides. We are left with only one option, that is firstly calculate this angle and then easily we can make the angles, make the quadrilateral. So let us calculate this angle L. I am taking, let us suppose this angle is X degree. Okay, so taking the sum of all the angles and put it equal to 360 degree, I will be getting the measurement of this L. Now, X plus 90 degree plus 85 degrees plus 110 degrees is equal to 360 degree. The reason being, sum of all the angles of a quadrilateral are 360 degree. So it will be, the sum of these three angles will be 285 plus x is equal to 360 degree. Now x equals 360 degree minus 285, that is equal to 75 degree. So angle L is equal to 75 degree. So this is 75 degrees. Now you can take either PL as base or LA as base, because these two angles are known, the dimension is also known to us. These two angles are known and the dimension is also known to us. I am taking LA as base. So let us begin the construction now. I am taking LA as base. That is equal to 6.5 centimeters. So this is LA, 6.5 centimeter. Now I need to make an angle of 75 degree at L, and we have seen the way how to make the angle 75 degree in the previous question also. So let us make it again now. This 75 degree angle lies between 60 degree and 90 degree. So I am making the angle 75 degree. So firstly I have made a semicircle at a point L, and then 60 degree arc, 120 and 180 I have made, then 90 degree angle I have made, and between 60 degree and 90 degree I have made an angle of 75 degree. Now at A point I need to make an angle of 110 degree, and dear children, I can make only those angles using compass which are divisible by 15 degree or which are multiples of 15 degree. It means if an angle that is 110 degree, this angle is not divisible or not a multiple of 15 degree, so I cannot use the compass to make this angle. So this angle that is 110 degree, I need to make it with the help of protractor. Like this I am making now. So simply using the protractor, I have made an angle of 110 degree. After that, LP is known to me, that is 4 centimeter. LP I am making 4 centimeter. So with AL as center, I will be placing an arc of 4 centimeter to get the point P. So this point is P and this LP or PL is 4 centimeter. Now at this point P, I need to make an angle of 90 degrees. So let us make an angle of 90 degree at point P. From this point, I am placing an arc of 60 degrees, and then 120 degrees, and then finally 180 degrees arc. After this, between 60 and 120 degrees, I need to make an angle of 90 degrees. This all of you know very well. So this is P, L, A and N. So this is our required quadrilateral. So in this question, basically, dear children, we have seen two different concepts. First is, we have calculated the unknown angle because we did not know the dimension of two sides. So we have calculated first angle by putting the sum of all the angles equal to 360 degrees. After that, we have come to know another concept that we can make only those angles by compass which are divisible or multiple of 15 degrees. So this is what we are supposed to keep in mind while constructing this question number 1, second part. Next topic which I am going to discuss is how to construct a quadrilateral when three sides and two included angles are given. Let us discuss this question with exercise 4.4. I am going to discuss this topic with the question number 1, first part of exercise 4.4. The question is, construct the following quadrilaterals. Quadrilateral DAR, that is DAR, I need to construct, in which DE is equal to 4 centimeters, EA is equal to 5 centimeters, AR is equal to 4.5 centimeters, angle E is equal to 60 degrees, and angle A is equal to 90 degrees. So these are the dimensions, and I'm going to discuss question number 1, first part of exercise 4.4 NCERT book. So let us get started with the rough sketch and then final sketch and then steps of construction. So this is the question, quadrilateral DAR we need to construct, and these are the dimensions. I'm going to discuss exercise 4.4, question number 1, first part. I am discussing this question number 1, first part of exercise 4.4 NCERT book. So DE is given to us as 4 centimeters, EA is given to us as 5 centimeters, AR is given to us as 4.5 centimeters, angle E is given to us as 60 degrees, and angle A is given to us as 90 degrees. So this is the case when the measurement of three sides are given to us. You can see these three sides measurements are given and two included angles are given to us. So this is what we are going to discuss now. So let us get started. I am taking EA as base because these two angles are known and the dimension of this EA is also known to us. If you are thinking to make AR as base, it is not possible because we do not know this angle. We cannot take this DE as base because we do not know this angle. If it would have been the availability of three angles, then we would have calculated this angle R, and then it can be done like we have done in the previous case. But here in this case, simply we are supposed to take EA as base, which is 5 centimeters. So let us now make it. Now at E, I need to make an angle of 60 degrees. This is very simple. I have made a semicircle and then simply 60 degree angle I have made. And at A, I need to make an angle of 90 degrees. Again, I am making a semicircle and 60 degree and 90 degree angle. This this is 90 degree angle. I am making 60 degree angle also. This is 60 degree angle. This is 90 degree angle. Now, EA I have taken as base. After that, AR is 4.5 centimeter. So measuring 4.5 centimeter with the help of scale and then placing an using compass, place an arc of 4.5 centimeters. So I have taken R point, and that is 4.5 centimeters. After that, ED is also known to us, that is 4 centimeter. So making 4 centimeter, making an arc of 4 centimeter with the help of compass now. This is our point D. Now we need to join this. So this is our required quadrilateral, that is DEAR. You can write the measurement. This is 4 centimeters. I hope, dear children, you have understood how to make the quadrilateral when three sides and two included angles are known to us. So it's time for the homework now. Dear children, you are supposed to complete exercise 4.3 and exercise 4.4 in your homework notebooks. As in today's lecture, we have discussed or we have learned how to construct a quadrilateral when two adjacent sides and three angles are known to us. Exercise 4.3 is based on this concept, and exercise 4.4 is based on the concept of constructing a quadrilateral when three sides and two included angles are given to us. So you are supposed to complete these two exercises in your homework notebooks. I have tried to explain the concepts. Still, if you have doubt, the doubts can be resolved in the online classes. That's all for today. Thank you so much.